young man is on his way to bigger things. Line abreast across the field, the full side is Eastern Suburbs. Kerry Boosted, Terry Fay, Ron Gitto, Noel Cleal, Steve McFarlane, Robert Lurie, Kevin Hastings, John Taven, Des O'Reilly, Paul McCabe, Royce Aylett, Jeff Martin and John Hovey, and the coach is Bob Fulton. Well, that man in the middle, more than anyone for Eastern Suburbs, number 11, Royce Aylett, their captain and prop, will have to withstand the murderous body contact the Eels forwards will put on early. He's got to not only withstand it, but he must remain constructive in keeping his backs going. His role is a critical one. The referee, Mr. Greg Hartley. Since Parramatta entered the first grade in 1947, there have been 82 games between these two clubs. Easter won 44, Parramatta won 36. Three drawn. The points for you can see, 13-45, 11-02. Last time East won at the Sydney Cricket Ground against Parramatta was March 79, 11-10. And the last time Parramatta won against Eastern Suburbs was September the in 77. And previous winners with Eastern Suburbs in possession, putting the ball back. East have won three times, 74, 77 and 79. Parramatta have won once, 75, beating Manly 11-5. A kicking duel developing, man in possession. Just inside his own half, that's a mountainous kick. Could go dead in goal. No, Boosted's got it in his own end goal. He's going to have to get out. He's lost. Oh, he very nearly lost the ball. It went to Fay rather fortuitously, and he's taken it 9 metres out. Aylett now doing the job he'll have to do all night. Now Easter on with a kick again. There's the rebound. It's been kicked dead over the off the back of a Parramatta player over the dead ball line. Play will restart from the goal line. It was always on with that kick. Field just couldn't get it high enough. Parramatta's kicking game very much in evidence. We spoke about that earlier, Barry Ross. The Parramatta coach Jack Gibson likely to put the kicking game on.
Oh, I think there's no doubt of that, Rex. Kerry Boosted, not a very tall fullback, and the bomb will test out any fullback, let alone a shorter.
We're talking about tall fullbacks. Oh, Bill, man, he's just run straight into them. They've obliged by running straight into him. Is offside. Opening penalty and a few fisticuffs. The referee in very, very quickly. Mick Cronin with the first opportunity of the night to kick a goal. And I'll just read some cup final rules to you. If the Craven Mile Cup is drawn at full time, the winner will be decided as the team scoring most tries. Should tries be equal, the team with the least number of penalties will be the winner. If penalties are equal, the team scoring the first try wins. If there are no tries and the penalties are equal, the team conceding the first penalty loses the match. And Cronin's missed from directly in front. A most unusual situation for Mick Cronin. The score remains pointless. Flight in the middle of the season kick, as we've done many times. 19 of 20 of those on the trot. Good man taking that beautifully. Tackle of Gitto was a good one. Ray Price, close to the ruck there, 10 metres inside Parramatta's half. Edge now big Bob O'Reilly. Swinging right arm from Eastern Suburbs forward. Stevens to win, looking for support, finds it out there with Glover. Massive fires on the ground. Glover emerges and a small knock-on took place. Players are really getting into each other. Parramatta have had a great start to proceedings tonight in the under-23s. They won 15-7. The reserve grade, they won 17-3. Penalty to Eastern Suburbs. Peter Sterling being penalised for failing to retire. O'Reilly and Aylett coming to grips. Field will kick the touch. Hastings hopping around the back play there with the sort of foot injury. Needs to restart. Masterman. Aylett, 10 metres, failing to retire the required them again. O'Reilly was the offender. Hastings getting a bit of treatment for that leg. Peel can put them within a scoring position here. They're up around the quarter line, which is a good position to attack to put on your moves. Mark Baylor. Harvey. There's a good tackle right round the legs, lifting and driving in hard. Laurie's hands, marvellous. All those big hits coming in from the Parramatta side. McCabe. Strong player, this player with a representative future in my view. Bentley against Parramatta, and I think he's well and truly got Ron Hilditch there. Should be an easy one. O'Reilly being called out, spoken to by referee Harvey. Probably had a bit of a chat. Crowd, a good crowd. It's really vocal. Also can boost it. Feel the kicking game on again. It's gone off the side of his foot a little bit. An off break and over the sideline. Well, if he's been practicing that this week, is O'Reilly applauding that one? Why not? Scrum will go down 10 metres into Parramatta's half. Good wind to Martin. Laurie, looking for Burstead. Out it comes along the line. Laurie, Cleal, trying to get on the burst. Hastings, Aleph, bad pass, a lot of ground. That'll be a knock on, I think. The referee says no, play on. Hastings. 2-0 East and Suburbs lead. There's a kick from Laurie. He's got a fine touch. It's a magnificent one. About 8 metres from the corner post. About 8 minutes of clock. That's a good attacking position. Scrums at this stage. With East and Suburbs having won the only completed scrum. Stephen Edge, I think, the man that's going to really control this game if he hooks true to form. There's 35 scrums from 68 in 81. Success rate over the half, 51.1. And he comes up with a very important scrum there. Stephen Edge for Parramatta. Clay Price. 10 metres out now from their line, Parramatta. O'Reilly. And they move in very smartly. I can't remember a player who's in better condition towards the end of his career than Bob O'Reilly. He's lost a massive amount of weight and looks trim and hard. Barry Ross, comment?
Yes, well, he's only 15 stone 13, Rex, and last season he was playing close to 17 stone, and that's just the hard work Bob put into it.
A little bit of a punch went into that tackle, and the penalty has gone to Parramatta. Fortune into John Harvey, who gave him a nice heavy shoulder check. Very much a feeling out stage. Now O'Reilly gets a good pass away to win. Deckard. Price. Stevens. Right through the gap. Oh, a lovely tackle right round the boots there on Hilditch. Stevens trying the kick. It ricochets. Mann has it. On the first bounce from another luckily bounced up for him. Six to go, says referee Hartley. Over pointing to his players and telling them to plug the gaps. a role in a price. Harvey getting through some very torrid defence in the opening stanza. Sterling Cronin. Enormously strong player. And there's going to be a penalty here against Eastern Suburbs. Taylor. With a very stern look, Hartley says penalty to Mick Cronin. Cronin's kick from that angle is not a great one. Doesn't make more than about a 10-metre gain. Edge. Sterling. Glover. Nearly busted the first line. About 9 metres into Eastern Suburbs half. Stevens. Now Stevens will have a go occasionally because he doesn't expect, the opposition don't expect him to try to make the bust himself. He's a ball user these days.
This is not a pack of fish fingers.
He's coming off a win in this, apart from the rewards. Man coming in. Got the ball now, it's gone behind him. But Kenny has it. Laurie chases out to Gross. This is danger for Eastern Suburbs. Look at Gross go. It's a top tackle. Oh, what a tackle. Close there. He won't do a more important one tonight, that Eric Gross, like Greasel Lightning, given a bit of room on the side. Now the scrum into Marcelin. Tobin standing out of the scrum. 3-2 the scrums in young Jeff Masterman's favour. Three. Oh, danger, danger. Bad one. Parramatta come up with the ball. Brothers got it. It's only about 10 metres out. They literally ride him into the ground. That was a bad pass from Cleal. Sterling. And Bob O'Reilly gets a pass away magically. Edge gets a better price. Price wrapped up about 9 metres out. He's had the ball stolen. Cleal's got it. Cleal got knees in the chest then. As Harvey straight and hard as a good prop should. Desperate moments for Eastern Suburbs. Now Alan. Bust in the first line. And a penalty. Swinging arm tackle. It's Ron Hilditch. I'll be very surprised if Bobby Fulton hasn't got something to say to Noel Cleal about that pass at halftime, Barry Ross.
Yes, that's right. Bob Fulton likes to play mistake-free football, and that just shouldn't happen so close to your line.
Harvey had about a flu last week, and he's come back refreshed. Got very much into the game in the opening stanza. Hastings. There's Cleal on the move. And they took him well round the boots. He couldn't get the pass away. It was a Stevens tackle. McCabe. Has that great ability to break tackles, but also lost the ball on that occasion. Parramatta come up with the dregs. Sterling. Cronin. Cronin. Leave that a metre from the sideline. 5 metres or so out from his quarter. Sterling. Bob O'Reilly. O'Reilly's ball using ability well on evidence in a couple of cases already. The Lich. O'Reilly. Stevens. Well, I'm back slam. Last tackle. Enough money on a kick. Well, you're going to move it along the back line. Long pass out from Cronin out to Brett Kinney. Now that's the six. Well, very much a game of defence in the opening 17 minutes. Gathers the impression already that the team that makes the least mistakes is going to win this one. Both sets of backs standing up very flat. Cronin unloaded beautifully. There's an overlap, but he can't get it away, can Kenny? And goes to ground heavily for his time. Farmer with a good spot tackle there. man. Suggestion of a shepherd there. What about Riley? Offside, says referee Hartley. Stevens is belted to the ground. It's the long and short of it in the Parramatta second row with Peter Witt well over 6 feet. Kevin Stevens, I suppose he'd be 5'9", would he, Barry Ross?
Around about that, Rex.
Gee, that's a terrible kick. No comment.
5'10", according to the official program.
I think that's with his uplifts on. Very broad and powerful man around the shoulders. I don't think anyone would classify him as tall. Over Riley. Bit of a dump sold on that occasion. 2-0, Eastern Suburbs lead. A penalty to Gitto from directly in front. O'Reilly got his pass away and it's the wrong one. Offside pass. Let's see that again. He held it up well. Steve Ella came on the burst. I had the impression it could have been forward. Now watch it again. Big Bob O'Reilly surges the defence. There it was. One gets the impression it was a live ball, but the referee, as you can see, almost directly in line with that. Leaving kick takes East back into an attacking position. There's O'Reilly. Harvey. By midfield, about 12 metres out from the Parramatta quarter. Harvey. Laurie. Long pass. It puts Burstead into the clear. Running nicely. Got plenty of pace. Goes through one tackle. Looks to support, got Laurie there, he'll take the tackle about 12 metres out. That was good stuff. A great pass from Laurie and both then ran onto it beautifully. Hastings, Baylor. Support not just where it needed to be on that occasion. Runaround move with McCabe, he loses the ball again and it comes back to him and he's offside. Penalty to Parramatta. Ricocheted out of his hands to a Parramatta player and then back into his hands in an offside position. The Parramatta line kicking has not been great. Not seemingly making the advantage they should in terms of distance. Sterling. Glover. A very sound handler is Neville Glover. Still called the magician for one incredible take he took at Cumberland Oval. He had the ball between his legs and still managed to score a try. Incredible. O'Reilly. Up the middle, looks for support. Beautiful pass to Ray Price. That was magic football. Win. The Ron Coote of the 80s. O'Reilly. Going hard now at this Parramatta pack. Pilditch, it's a bit of a surf from Des O'Reilly there. Sterling, a high bomb, not put deep enough to cause trouble. Masterman, I think, has fallen on it for Eastern Suburbs. As well he did. Terry Fay just can't seem to get himself into a position to get in the clear. Tobin. 10 metres outside the quarter. East lead 2-0. We've got 14 minutes to go to half-time. The kick from Cleal is a long one. Growth. Good tackle. Philip Mann, the tallest player in Sydney Rugby League. Win a bet on that. Nick Cronin very casually took that one-handed. Bob O'Reilly. Bob O'Reilly. Still managing to be past the Price. It was beautiful football. Look at the outside for Kenny. He's unloaded. Kenny will score. I don't think there's any goal. Pass back inside. It's beautiful. Last try. That taken by is a clip.
Ray Price
backing up on the inside. And what wonderful football from Bob O'Reilly initially. Then Ray Price backing up, unloaded the pass well, backed up on the inside, but see it again. Particularly watch the Bob O'Reilly bit of football here. Now watch him. Gets through that tackle. As he was falling, unloaded to Price on the burst. Brett Kenny got away from his defender. Gitto. The pass back inside was great. And did you see the way Price picked that up? What a great one from head on. Now O'Reilly's skill again, well and surely in evidence. Price calling for it. Finds the gap. You'll notice that the defence is coming across pretty fast. That pass back inside. Gee, that took a bit of football skill to pick that one up too, I'll tell you. Two tries in 1980. It's his second try in 81. The kick at goal is unsuccessful. The score remains. Parramatta 3. Eastern Suburbs 2. Well, there's nothing wrong with rugby league when trials like that can be scored. Gitto just found a little bit wanting for pace there with Kenny getting outside and away from him. Parramatta again. Cronin. Price. Unloaded. Ella. Using his acceleration nicely. Stevens out to O'Reilly. What a top tackle there too from Tobin. Parramatta putting players through gaps nicely at the moment. Sterling with a nice step. Nice tackle coming up. At 10 minutes to half time. O'Reilly cuts out a man, out to Cronin. It's a pass back on the inside, it's gone to ground. Who's got it? Eastern Suburbs.
Jeff Masterman.
Masterman is always Johnny on the spot for that loose ball. I think that's the third occasion tonight he's fallen on a ball that could have gone to the other team. Blind sides, rolling end over end. Won't get the sideline. Grove has it. Delays the first tackle. Up to the quarter line. Good run. Error situation. Parramatta have conceded the ball four times. Back to the opposition. Eastern Suburbs twice. Cronin. Lovely pass. Dummy's been thrown. A flick back inside to Glover. Kenny's showing great maturity. He's running a penalty. He's gone to Parramatta. Well, Brett Kenny is a player that came out of the Parramatta Juniors. And Barry, do you know much about him?
No, he came from the Guildford club and been with Parramatta two or three seasons.
Mick Cronin bleeding rather heavily from the mouth or nose by the look of it. Some gaps being created now in this Eastern Suburbs forward defence. Here's Bob O'Reilly looking for the ball, but he doesn't get it. Stevens gives it away nicely to Sterling, and Sterling gets up and down and loses the ball. And East have come up with it through McCabe. Tobin. Harvey. Laurie. Ella's done a good job on Laurie tonight. Harvey inside to Cleal. He busts the first line. Sorry. Ella. 9 metres outside the quarter. Tobin has a run. Swap him. Over the top on this occasion. Man's going to be lucky enough to get that easily on the second bounce. Just to keep his elbows down. So he could have been talked there by the referee on that one. Price, they're moving the ball well now, Parramatta. Cronin, out to Kenny. nice little in and away, a little shuffle he does with his feet. Across to that priceless acceleration. Stevens with a diving pass.
Blood coming from a cut around Mick Cranan's nose or mouth.
Yes, we've had a shot of him on there. Peter Wynn has the ball ricocheted out of his hands. McFarlane has it. He's wrapped up straight away. Goes to Harvey. 8 minutes to go. 3-2, Parramatta lead. One try in the match today. Magnificent effort. Started by O'Reilly. Scored by Price. Aylock. Head, run around. Ito picked off rather easily there. Hastings, Harvey. The pass away. It should be six to go. It is. Touch the Parramatta player. O'Reilly. Now Eastern Suburbs are starting to bunch up in the forwards. Laurie, Tobin. Sure sign that the team's getting tired when they do that. There's O'Reilly. Strong bust. That's the way to run. That's the way to get your team on the move forward. Laurie turns it back inside to McCabe. Big fella to the quarter line. Hastings. Harvey. Nice pass to Bosley. Changes direction. Gets a pass inside and it's gone to ground. Masterman again there to pick up the dregs. That's the fourth time he's picked up the loose ball and unloaded. Worry. Worry gets a beautiful pass away to Goodell. Goodell scores! Inside the post. And all from the Masterman pass. They might have just come up with a beauty in this fella. Eastern Suburbs 5, Parramatta 3. See that one again. Now watch Masterman carefully here, number 12, because he does everything right. There's the loose ball. There's Masterman. Takes the tackle. Not put down. Fights himself free. One-hands it. And from there, Laurie is able to set the business going because he ran nicely and unloaded perfectly into Gitto. Came on the burst hard and straight. And that's the try. Again from head-on. I commend this work done by Masterman. Beautiful stuff. Keeping the ball alive. No real danger in the pass. You can see he hasn't got that right arm held in any way. Laurie did beautifully. Gitto got inside the defence and scores adjacent to the post. And I'd like to see him dive on top of that. 8 tries at 19.80 did Ron Gitto score. Probably about 18 metres out. Less perhaps, 15 metres. 10 metres off centre. Caught and kick. No trouble at all. So then, Eastern Suburbs have come up with a handy lead going into half-time. Well, it may not be a lead at half-time. There's still about 4 minutes to go, but Eastern Suburbs 7, Parramatta 3.
We want a rugged work machine with a comfort solid car. The beauties you get ever has been that has ever been seen so far.
What about it, Mazda made a Ute with all the quality the name commands? Diesel power and capacity, every tradesman's trade demands.
One of the Parramatta side trailing. Suburbs lead by 7 points to 3. And we've had one change in the Parramatta team. No changes in Eastern Suburbs. Mick Cronin is off. And he's replaced by Ella, who goes back to the centre. Sterling goes to 5-8, we are told. And that young man that just kicked the ball, Stephen McKenzie, is at halfback. Now, McKenzie came on against Penrith, was on the field for 10 minutes, and scored 2 tries. And Barry Ross, you may have some further information on him.
He's from the Central Coast, came down for a tryout. He's not young, about not young as football standards go, 25, 26, and just came down to try his luck and has done very well.
All right, the ball lying loose now, and the referee has gone for the penalty. Masterman drags Edge along the ground. A little display of hooker against hooker. Grabbed him by the jersey and dragged him away. And he's going to be spoken to about it. Funny little incident. Just let's see that again if we can. It's only a little bit of byplay. Nothing serious, nothing malicious. Nothing. I'm quite amused by it, actually. watch this. You'll see how hookers get involved in the play. There's Edge burrowing away. Now watch Masterman come around the back. Now watch Edge. There he is over the top of him and drags him by the jumper backwards. Around the corner kicker. Bring it in, and not quite enough, but went very, very close. The score remains 7, Eastern Suburbs, Parramatta 3. McKenzie does the kickoff. Hastings was the ball carrier. Warming in again, they've got it all to do. A lot of money at the end of this rainbow, $26,000 for the winner. A lot different to $9,000 for runner-up. The blind side comes Harvey. Des O'Reilly on the halfway line. Hastings. Tobin. Well tackled on the halfway line. Players on the Eastern Suburbs side running around the ruck. Hastings turns it back on the inside. Harvey straight and very, very hard. And that was the sixth. Now there's been a change in what I told you. This is the first scrum we've seen since half time. Fed by Sterling and McKenzie's at 5'8". And he's been beaten on that occasion. The ball has been knocked from the Eastern Suburbs player's hands. There's no knock-on call. The referee coming in for a bit of booing for that one. And play about 2 metres now from Parramatta's quarter line. Hitto. Laurie. McCabe on the quarter line. Masterman at dummy half. Hastings. Lurie, dummies inside. There's Cleal. Oh! Great defence there by Ron Hilditch. It's a high kick gone. There's pressure for Phil Mann. They jump. Who's got it? Eastern Suburbs have come up with the ball. No. It's a knock-off. Well, Phil Mann appeared to be pushed a little bit out of the way there. Jeff Masterman scrums one 13. 25 and 81. Bob Fulton will be pretty happy if he keeps that more than 50% ratio going. Sterling's got the pass out to Glover. He did a little bit of clear that was on the right wing. Always good for some game. Stevens. Hilditch. Pass spilled. And that'll be a knock on both ways. Bit of frantic football then by Parramatta. Trying to keep the momentum going. Was at this stage, only won the difference, 5 to Eastern Suburbs, 4 to Eastern Suburbs, 5 to Parramatta, penalty to Eastern Suburbs. Hastings trying desperately to get the ball away, now watch him go. The referee has wisely, now he's penalised one of the Parramatta players for failing to get back the required distance. And it was Peter Wynn, so now the differential penalty has been overruled, and there'll be a kick and goal from Gitto. And I think Bobby Fulton would be pretty happy with that Floyd. So the kick will go ahead. Price adopts his praying mode. That's a terrible kick that went absolutely straight. Straight where he was aiming it, or where his legs seemed to go, out way out to the right. They get a line dropout.
Interest rates are rising. It's your money. Make the most of it. This week's Sun Herald features the...
Left footer downfield from McKenzie. First head. Sterling sliding down and up. McKenzie finishes the job. Laurie. That's a terrible pass. out. Who's got it now? Fay. Unloaded well to Laurie. Backing up. I think he had support out there on the left. He could well have given that pass. Hastings. Ella. Cleal. Still going. Reese Sellers is nice and deep at the moment. Hastings kicking. Not a kick for Mann to take lightly. Got him against the sideline. Fay takes him and well. Right round the leg. Growth managed to get his pass away to McKenzie. Loses the ball. And knock on. The referee says that Parramatta came up with the ball from one of their own knock-ons. Scrum. Penalty ratio very heavily in the error ratio very heavily in favour of Eastern Suburbs at the moment. Parramatta have created 9 errors, Eastern Suburbs 2. Gitto wrapped up before he could unload. Now they go. The Blinders an opening out here. Fay have got an overlap. Cleal strongly. It's a pass away to McFarlane. It wasn't a good one. Knocked on. Manera is creeping into the second half. Get to that one. Philip Mann trying to penetrate. And does that. Unloaded the pass. The ball's gone. Ricochet. McLean's got it. And a one-handed pass to Taven. And back come Eastern Suburbs to the quarter line. Hastings. Ayla. Took the tackle. Couldn't give a pass successfully. The blind side comes Marston. But a Des O'Reilly. And some strong body contact again. Hildich over the top with a strong tackle.
Parramatta could be making another change. Jeff Coburn coming onto the arena.
Cleal taken from behind and skips through that tackle too. Powerful play. Okay. Hastings, Masterman, Aleph, Bosted, pass the ground, picked up by Eastern Suburbs. That by Parramatta, Stephen Edge. Sides committing some fundamental errors here, like that. The referee says no knock on, play on. That was a miraculous catch. O'Reilly, good pass out there. Kenny, better growth. He's up the sideline. He's got the place. Yes, he's got through one tackle, two, and a top tackle. Coming across there from Rocky Laurie, puts him in a touch, 10 metres, Eastern Suburbs side of halfway. Great football. Touch judge on. Hildich is off. Jeff Coburn is on. It's a very messy looking scrum, but at least somebody can come up with it. Wellstead penetrates. Hastings. Dippo, the run around with Coburn. Taven looks for support. He's got a long pass out there to Farland. He's up the sideline and tackled. In a touch again. Some great cover. Coburn playing in what number? 17. Still the score. Eastern Suburbs 7. Parramatta 3. Suburbs with the second scrum in a succession. Fullback gets it straight away. Oh, and a terrible pass goes to Gitto. It's going to be kicked through, is it? The referee says, play on. Eastern Suburbs have come up with it. Six to go. Hastings. Fay. He's not been able to get into the clear at all with this Eastern Suburbs side since I've seen him play. Gitto. Parramatta defence not quite as airtight as it was earlier. Masterman running from dummy half. And don't think twice about it again. Laurie Fay taking them on the forwards. Big enough to. 10 metres out from Parramatta's line. Midfield. Hastings. Harvey. Hastings. Run around move there. And Tobin on the boil, but the pass didn't go to him. Harvey. Kick goes high. Man under pressure. Oh, Sterling looked at that and looked at Man. It's got to be a knock-on. Got to be a knock-on. Well, that was a terrible bit of football by Sterling and Man. One looked at the other. Sterling thought it was going to be Man, and Man made no attempt for it. See that again, quickly. Up goes the kick. Now watch young Sterling, number 7. He looks at Man there. Right, back to the normal action. And that's a penalty to Eastern Suburbs. It's against. Sterling for not retiring. Now in that situation, the players had only to, the Parramatta players had only to retire to the goal line. Judge has got the Parramatta players lined up. It's O'Reilly. Now let's see whether young Masterman can work the Oracle again with a clever bit of dummy half play. He did last week, but there's O'Reilly. Tobin a dummy half. Gitto. Little stutter with his feet trying to off put the defence. Okay, quick hands from Harvey, but the pass went to Hastings backwards. Tobin. And there's a bit of shepherding there by Eastern Suburbs player Tobin. And the penalty goes to Eastern Suburbs to Parramatta. Now the statistics of the match thus far. Eastern Suburbs hooker Marston is doing a good job. 7-6, he's in front. And the penalties have gone to Eastern 10-7. 4-1 in the second half to Eastern Suburbs. Still to go. 7 points to 3. Eastern Suburbs lead. I think he's lost the ball in that belly.
You can forget about pink elephants, forget about the fun. Forget the hoppin', hoppin', forget about the buzz. You're okay.
And you see highlights of this match. Discussion of all rugby league matters. Penalty to Eastern Suburbs. The controversy corner panel. Another interesting guests on the show, notably Tony Gregg, former England cricket captain, here we are, talking to David Lord. Sterling. Growth driven sideways by Harvey. About 10 metres from halfway. Parramatta territorially have not been in this second half. Stephen. A little bit of grafting to get the ball into an attacking position. Still plenty of time for a result either way. Sterling to Man. Oh, Harvey ran straight into it. Knocking base over apex. There's plenty of base in that apex. 6'5". Halfway. Sterling. Bob O'Reilly. Pass has gone astray. Who's got it? Coburn. One-handed pass out to Kenny. Panic stations. Panic stations as Faye kicks him. It's a race for the ball. This could be Derek Faye. Could be a try. It's a try. Is that the referee? Well back. And he's ruled a penalty to Parramatta, and he's ruled that there was interference. Pushing, and we'll see that again. The referee not in the least bit interested. He's claiming that Faye held onto the jumper. And right from the outset, there was very messy football in this. Passes were going astray. There were one-handed panic passes. Well, from side on, we just didn't capture the action of Faye doing any jumper pulling. There may be suggested he didn't ground the ball correctly through. But nonetheless, it's an interesting incident. Maybe a head-on shot would have shown the jumper pulling on that, but we'll pass on that. There's another loss of possession by Parramatta. Oh, they've come up with the ball. The referee has not ruled on the forward pass. Went to Price. Always able to break the one tackle, doesn't it? Puts it to Grove, goes through one tackle up the sideline. How he managed to stay away from the sideline, I'll never know. Incredibly strong run. That's six to go. Sterling. Parramatta's one of their rare opportunities to get it within tacking distance. Ella. Well tackled. Now Sterling. O'Reilly. Wrapped up. Still managed to get a pass away to Ray Price. He gets it to McKenzie. McKenzie going very close. He's only about a metre away, and that's a six. He's got acceleration. Little doubt about that. Scrums 8-7 each way. Top job by Martin. 7-3 Eastern Suburbs lead. China goal for Parramatta. They're in front. Kiddo skips through one tackle of Ella. He's been a little bit fragile in defence. Hastings grubber kick is a good tactical ploy, gets them out of their half. They were playing in the centre alongside Brett Kenny, McKenzie at 5'8", Sterling at halfback, Cronin from the field in the second half.
Parramatta change. John Beecher taking the arena.
Here's Noel Cleal. See this put out of the ball. 10 tries and a goal. 32 points in 1980. Three tries in 81.
Eastern Suburbs is about to make two changes. Ian Barclay wearing number 16 is on the sideline, and Dave Brown wearing number 17.
Ron Giddo attempting the conversion of the Cleal try, fifth attempt. And successful. So Eastern Suburbs got this game virtually at their mercy now. Eastern Suburbs 12, Parramatta 3. Jumper number 16 to replace Peter Witt. Placement in action straight away. That's Ian Barclay. I think he's somewhat of a surf swimmer, isn't he, Barry?
No, he's an, I don't know if he, well, probably he is. I don't know if he's an outstanding one, but he's an Australian Steelboy Rugby League representative and came to Eastern Suburbs from the Newcastle area.
Well, Hastings is really putting his kicking game together now. And, you saw that error count earlier. Parramatta have created the errors, 13-5. Stage. That's the number of times they've given the ball back to the opposition. wheel has somewhat fallen off. Sterling goes careering back. Coburn about 9 metres outside his quarter. Stevens on the blind side of the ruck to O'Reilly. Price. And gives the ball back to the opposition. Clay has it. 16 errors. And Barkley. Placement. Marksman at a dummy half. Diving pass away to Hastings. Aylock. It's quite a very strong game. So, 15 metres out, loses the ball. Referee says he dropped it, and that'll be a scrum. Sterling has it. John Beecher, 2 metres from the quarter line. 12-3 the score. Pass back inside to Mann. Well knocked down by Des O'Reilly tackle. Bob O'Reilly still trying to put people through gaps. Stevens, Price loses the ball forward. Error number 17. Eastern Suburbs picking up these dregs of lost possession and turning the Parramatta side around constantly. Laurie. Nice. Hastings. Malith loses the ball. Picked up there by number 17, Jeff Coburn. Loomed up for Sterling, he goes halfway through it, scruff to the ground. O'Reilly looking for work. Back to Edge, then on to Coburn. Parramatta go up the middle. At 9 minutes to go, 12-3, Eastern Suburbs lead. Stevens kicking tactically, it's not going to find touch, it's rolling, or is it? Oh, well, close that helped it on its way, what do you say? I think he helped to kick it over the line there and his effort to get to it. And it's only about 5 metres out from the corner post.
Before this scrum goes down, Rex, I've had word from the Parramatta camp about Mick Cranor's injury. It's a strained heel.
Right, strained heel and a cut head at some stage. Eastern Suburbs, again, a very critical scrum for Masterman to win. And he's won some critical ones. Defence there by Beecher. There's O'Reilly. Little panic pass to get it away to Hastings. Hastings looks for support. Gets it outside nicely. It looks like Barkley heading with Farland. He's run out of support for plenty of Parramatta defence. The two players having an altercation in back play.
Kevin Hastings from Eastern Suburbs and Neville Glover from Parramatta.
Well, you wouldn't have to look very happy. See Neville involved, he likes a bit of a set two from time to time. Aylock. Hiddo to Cleal, that step for a big man, that's incredibly good. Cleal unloads beautifully to Hiddo. Hiddo's looking for support, throws the dummy, run out of support now. Gets it to Bosted. Bosted's like a basketball player, raising his hand in the air. Parramatta on the rack at the moment. Spade trying to bulldoze his way. Oh, and he went perilously close to scoring, but that's the sixth. Half a metre away. Time ticking away for Parramatta. 12-3. The score in Eastern Suburbs' favour. 2 tries to 1. Parramatta come up with another ball scramble. Out along the line it goes. Kenny. Got away from Hito on one occasion. The player down, writhing in agony at the moment.
Ray Price.
Stevens. There's an opening here. As Beecher goes, as Coburn goes well up the field. Out then to Aaron Grant. He's got the pace to go on with this. The most end tacklers have a copybook up and over the sideline. The most end really pulling off some superb tackles. Course for Parramatta, but rugby league's a funny game. Certainly can't win without the ball. Eastern Suburbs. Craven out floating among the backs. Parramatta starting to leave gaps. As O'Reilly goes for a jog.
Parramatta to make one more change. Paul Taylor wearing number 21 is going to the sideline.
Long floating pass out to Taylor. And to get back. Bosted chips over his own feet. Falls, loses the ball. And that probably is the only mistake he's made all night, apart from helping the ball over the sideline. Coburn comes up with a grip. Price is on his feet, thankfully. Back to the front. Probably 3.5 minutes to go, unofficial time. Sterling still trying hard. Ella. Little gap. Kenny's loomed up on the inside. He's got support both sides. He's thrown it anywhere. Or was it a kick? I couldn't see what he did with that, but the referee has ruled that it goes to Eastern Suburbs.
It's correct, really. It did come off an Eastern Suburbs player's hand and went backwards as far as these were concerned, and so they regained the ball.
It was such a frightful pass. If it was a pass, I really couldn't tell whether it was a kick or a pass. I think young Miller's bubble has burst a little bit tonight. That's a little bit too soon for him. He got beaten by Rocky Laurie once early in a little stepping duel, and that might have off-put him a bit. Suburb still using the tactical ploy of the kick to get them out of trouble with great results, as you can see, back to halfway. Statistically, we'll go through the game for you as the dying moments approach. The errors have been horrendous as far as Parramatta is concerned. 16 times they've given the ball back to the opposition to 8 for Eastern Suburbs. That's, 2-1 situation. So there's your ball game right from the outset. The fact that young Masterman has done marvellously well against Stephen Edge and half the scrums at 10-all at this stage. The penalties are 10-11. So he's only one behind, which is a great performance. The penalties have gone to Eastern Suburbs by 10-9 at this stage.
Ray Price has left the field and Paul Taylor's on for him, and Robert Lane is on the sideline for Eastern Suburbs, ready to take someone else's place.
I think Parramatta fans will be starting to wonder whether there's a jinx on this ground for them. Out it comes along the line. Number 17 there, standing wide as Jeff Coburn. Got it to Growth. Growth, a great player, a player that can make the break. John.
He's bringing Robert Lane on the Eastern Coast to replace it wearing number 14.
Robert Lane on, I think Tobin off. Lane has gone to halfback. And Hastings is going to go to 5-8. Lane involved right away with Hastings. Time run fresh out, under a minute to go according to our time, which is unofficial. Very grateful, a lot of pain with an injured wrist. Bosted managed to get a pass to Faye couldn't handle it. pass at the moment. Grove's leaving the field. This is how it's come up with the scrum win. Laurie. Back to line. Shows a nice step. Another error. Picked up by Ella. Give it to Glover. The hooter goes in the background. That's the ball game. The Craven Mile Cup has gone to Eastern Suburbs for 1981 with a scoreline that reads 12 points to 3. The score is for the Eastern Suburbs side. There have been two tries. One to Noel Cleal, one to Ron Gitto, and Gitto has kicked three goals from five attempts. The Parramatta side, their try came up through the effort of Ray Price after some very good lead-up work by Bob O'Reilly to set them on five. But Cronin couldn't kick a goal, and they've had none from two attempts. So really a spirited performance by both sides. Many too many errors by Parramatta, something that Jack Gibson, their coach, is going to have to work on. Both coaches have used as many players as they possibly could.
Well, the final of the Craven Mile Cup was won on one statistic. If you have a look at the errors, you'll see exactly why Parramatta went down by 12 points to 3. And it's a very bland recital of the fact that rugby league is a game in the main that goes to the team that makes the least errors. Parramatta committed 17 cardinal sins. On 17 occasions, they gave the ball back to the opposition. Eastern Suburbs came up with a tally of 9. So almost a 2-to-1 ratio, and that's something I'm sure Jack Gibson, their coach, was going to be very, very unhappy about. It was an interesting game. I thought the tries that were scored were quite good. I am frankly still in a state of shock about the panic that took over in the Parramatta side. Some of the passing, one-handed basketball or water polo style passing, were just things that I've never seen from the Parramatta side before. Why they would pick the final to do it, I've got no way of knowing, but I'm sure Jack Gibson will do a little bit of psychoanalysis and find out. It's going to be a very interesting week, I would think, at the Parramatta Club this week to find out exactly what the team is going to be to take on the first competition match of the season. Well, that wraps up our pre-season coverage. We start off very shortly with the Premiership round. We've got to make decisions on which games to cover. If you keep watching the 7th Network news, you'll be made aware as soon as we make the decision. This is Rex Mossop from the Sydney Cricket Ground.
Since the league pre-season competition is now over, 7's Big League will of course not be on tomorrow night at 6:30. Instead, we bring you a marvellous new special about the history of Australian television commercials. You'll love it. It's on at 6:30 tomorrow night. 7's Big League starts up with the first round of the Premiership competition on Sunday week. That's the 29th of March. But right now, stay with us for Night Moves.